morning students, welcome back to social science class. I hope you all are doing fine. Today we are going to see the history chapter 1. The name of the chapter, the birth of modern India, when, where and how. Take your social science book, page number 127. According to historians, the modern period of Indian history began with the death of last great Mughal emperor Aurangzeb in 1707. Though people from different European countries had reached the Indian soil much earlier, it was only under the successor of Aurangzeb, collectively called the later Mughals, that the road to their political, economic and cultural domination over the Indian subcontinent was paved. The process of this domination, as we shall read later in this book, began with the grant of trading rights by Indian rulers to the European trading companies, and reached a high pitch with conflicts among them for supremacy in trade and politics. After successfully fighting a series of battles against their French rivals and some powerful Indian rulers, the British emerged as the dominant power in the subcontinent. So according to historians, the duration of this period, ancient, so the Indian history was divided into three periods: ancient, medieval and modern period. The medieval period considered as the Mughal period, like Babur, Humayun, Akbar ruled over India, was a part of the medieval period. And the modern period of India began with the death of the last great Mughal emperor Aurangzeb. Already you have, as you have studied in the class 7th, Mughal emperor. So after the death of Mughal emperor Aurangzeb, the people are from different European countries. People are from different European countries means like Portuguese, Dutch, English and French. They reached Indian soil much earlier. It was only under the successor of Aurangzeb, collectively called the later Mughals. After Aurangzeb, nine rulers ruled the territories of Mughals. So this Mughal called as the later Mughals. After the death of Aurangzeb, nine rulers ruled the territories of Mughals. So these nine rulers are called as later Mughals. So these rulers gave the trading rights. These rulers grant of trading rights by the to the trading gave the trading rights to the European trading company. First, European entered into India as yet for a trade purpose only. So slowly they have to reach the peak in the trade. So they have slowly entered into the politics also, as well as among the European country they were fight each other, who is powerful, who has to occupy entire India. So after successfully fighting a series of battles against the French, so among the European, French and British is the more powerful. So they have to try for supremacy and establish their own empire in India. Who? French and British. So finally, British emerged as the dominant power in the subcontinent. Is it clear? So after the death of last Mughal emperor, that period is considered as the modern period. After death of Aurangzeb, nine rulers ruled the territories of Mughals. So that rulers are called as later Mughals. Who are later Mughals? After death of Aurangzeb's successor, nine rulers ruled the territories of Mughals. So they are called later Mughals. These later Mughals only gave the, at that time, during later Mughals period time, lot of different European countries had reached the Indian soil much earlier. Reached the Indian soil for trading purpose only, because these later Mughals gave the rights to trading rights to the European countries. So when they entered into the European, when the European trading companies reached an high pitch with conflicts, so among themselves there was the, they, because they are getting more profits among them, they have the competition, among them they have the fight also. Who is the powerful? They want to establish their own empire in India. So French and British is the most powerful among the European countries. Finally, British emerged as the dominant power in the subcontinent. Is it clear, students? Next paragraph. While the period of 5 decades between 1707 CE and 1757 CE marks the formative years of British rule in India, it also saw the decline and disintegration of the Mughal Empire, characterized by the emergence of regional powers such as Bengal, Hyderabad, and the Marathas. Apart from the trade wars that occasionally brought the European trading companies into conflict over the issues of their mercantile interests and aspirations, a number of politically important events that took place during this period did not directly relate to the rise and expansion of the British power. We have already read about this most of the events in class 7. In this class, we shall touch upon the trade wars among the European companies and certain other related events in some detail to suggest how the transition from Mughal India to British India came about. The focus of our study, however, will be on the events that took place during the period of about 190 years between 1757 and 1947, when India became independent from the British rule after a long struggle for freedom. Look at this chart. So already I told, after Aurangzeb, after death of Aurangzeb, 9 rulers ruled the territories of Mughals. So these 9 rulers are called as later Mughals. These 9 rulers are called as later Mughals, who are all here. See, Bahadur Shah, Jahandar Shah, Farukh Shah, Muhammad Shah, Ahmad Shah, Alam Kir, Shah Alam, Akbar II, Bahadur Shah II. So which year they ruled, then ruler's name, everything, all details was given here. So you can see. Okay. So of this in India, so now one question I will ask. Here one question I will ask. Why did the Mughal Empire break down after Aurangzeb? What is the reason? So up to Aurangzeb, the Mughal Empire was very strong, isn't it? So from Babur to Aurangzeb. So after Aurangzeb, what happened to Mughal Empire? Why did the Mughal Empire break down after Aurangzeb? So after Aurangzeb death, in 1707, the Mughal Empire were into rapid decline. So the later Mughals, I told you these 9 rulers, Mughal rulers, are called as the later Mughals. So these later Mughal rulers did not have the capabilities needed to hold this vast empire together. They did not have the capabilities needed to hold this vast empire together. Powerful new kingdoms were established by the Marathas and Sikhs, the rulers of Hyderabad, Awadh, Karnataka and Bengal ruled independently over their provinces. These new powers constantly fought for supremacy among themselves. So once again I will repeat. In India, the modern period began in the 18th century after 1707 only, when the last great Mughal emperor Aurangzeb breathed his last. With the passing of Aurangzeb, the old Egypt began to crumble, giving place to new ideas and new institutions. Old powers began to weaken. When this old powers means here, this Mughal emperor, so Aurangzeb, up to Aurangzeb, this old powers began to weaken and many new powers began to emerge on the political horizon of India. The once mighty Mughals gradually slipped into the background, and the new powers, here new powers like Marathas, Sikhs, Pathans, Rajputs began to steal the soap. Their mutual, even new powers also came, but there was no unity among themselves. Also conflicts will be there. Their mutual conflicts invited various foreign powers like the Portuguese, the Dutch, the English and the French try for supremacy and establish their own empire in India. So in India, among rulers, there was no unity. Even new after the Mughal emperor, so later Mughals also Then later Mughal rulers also did not have the capabilities. So powerful new kingdoms were established. So among themselves also there was no unity. So their mutual conflicts invited various foreign powers like Portuguese, Dutch and English and French. They are trying for supremacy and establish their own empire in India. Is it clear? How the transition from Mughal India to British India came about? The focus of our study, however, will be on the events that took place during the period of about 190 years between 1757 and 1947, when India became independent from the British rule after a long struggle for freedom. So now modern period considered as the period of about 190 years between 1757 to 1947. So the transition from Mughal India to British India. So after the death of Aurangzeb, the transition from Mughal India to British India came about. This period, this 190 years between 1757 and 1947, when India became independent from the British rule after a long struggle for freedom. Let us start with the discussion on the factors rooted in European history itself that accounted for the transformation of the British from a group of traders into architect of India's destiny before the country attained independence. We shall also discuss why the period of British rule in India also called the colonial period of Indian history. Why the period of British rule? So British ruled over in India 1757 to 1947. Is also called the colonial period of Indian history. Is it clear, students? Transition in European society. From the 17th century, many new ideas, philosophies, and institutions started gaining popularity. Subsequently, sweeping changes occurred in the general outlook, perception, and worldview of people. These ideas, philosophies, and institutions also inspired people to look for new means and technologies of production and undertake expeditions to distant lands. They gradually realized that these distant lands could open up sources of raw materials for their domestic industries and help them to discover new markets for the consumption of their products. The term modern was originally used for the period of European history that encompassed all these developments, starting with the collapse of the medieval feudal system and culminating in the Industrial Revolution. In world history, the modern period includes a number of other important events such as American War of Independence, the French Revolution, formation of Italy and Germany, and two world wars, etc. Of all these events, however, the Industrial Revolution in Europe clearly relates to British rule in India. The most prominent aspect of the modern period in Indian history, it would be worthwhile, therefore, to touch upon the key features and effects of the Industrial Revolution that went on to shape the modern Indian history to a large extent as we know it today. Let us explain this paragraph, Transition in European Society. In the 17th century, many new ideas, philosophies and institutions started gaining popularity. When many new ideas changes, so transitions means here, transition means changes. When lot of changes occurred in the general outlook, perception and world view of people. So this, when new ideas, new changes are coming, so people, these ideas and philosophies and institutions also, these new ideas, philosophies inspired people to look for new means and technologies of production and undertake expedition to distant lands. They gradually realized that these distant lands could open up source of raw materials for their domestic industry and help them to discover new markets for the consumption of their products. So when they gradually realized that these lands could open for their source of raw materials for their domestic industries. So they have the domestic industry, but they don't have the raw materials. So it will help them to discover new markets. So they are taking the raw materials from us and to discover a new market for the conception of their products. The term modern was originally used for the period of European history that encompassed all these developments, starting with the collapse of medieval feudal system and culminating in the Industrial Revolution. So when the term modern was originally used, period of European history means all the developments of starting with this feudal system, you know, zamindars, landlords, all are having the power to control the farmers. But this system was totally collapsed in the medieval feudal system and culminating Industrial Revolution. So now culminating means started the new Industrial Revolution, because now lot of raw materials are available for their industry. So these new changes culminating in the Industrial Revolution. In world history, the modern period means it will include a number of other important events, such as the American War of Independence in 1783, the French Revolution in 1789, then formation of Italy, Germany, and the two world wars, First World War and Second World War. So of all these events, the Industrial Revolution in Europe clearly relates to the British rule in India. The most prominent aspect of the modern period in Indian history. Actually, Industrial Revolution in Europe clearly relates to the British rule, because whatever in they have the industry, okay, but the raw material with the new, these changes means caused by introduction new technology, invention of new mechanical so devices in the European 18 and 19. So they have that industrial product rate. So they have the industries that they are taking the raw materials from India. So this Industrial Revolution in Europe clearly relates to the British rule in India. So the most prominent aspect of the modern period in Indian history. It would be worthwhile therefore to touch upon the key features and effects of the Industrial Revolution. They went on to the shape of the modern Indian history to large extent as we know it today. Is it clear, students? So today we have discussed why did the Mughal Empire break down after Aurangzeb, then what kind of transition was the European society witnessing during the 17th century. Is it clear, students? That's all for today's class. I hope you all understood. Meet you in the next class. Till then, revise the chapter talk. Thank you. Have a nice day.